to Seven Sports' live telecast of the 1994 Grand Final Parade down Swanston Street in the centre of Melbourne, and the city has come to a standstill for the parade of Geelong and the West Coast Eagles, the combatants tomorrow in the Grand Final at the MCG. It's a different sort of parade this year. We've got dancers, we've got floats, and of course we've got the teams. We'll be speaking to captains and coaches a little bit later on. With me is Bernie Quinlan, soon to be the Fitzroy coach, and your last official duty with Seven Sports.
Yes, that's right, Drew, and a very exciting time in Melbourne at this time of the year with this big parade, and I would say it's the biggest and best by far that I've seen.
It is a buzz. In fact, we only just made it on time because the city, as I said, has come to a standstill.
Absolutely, yeah.
Well, we'll look forward
everywhere
to this. And out on the road is a veteran of 8 Grand Final parades, Robert Dippier-Domenico, 8 times as a player with Hawthorn, but now as a roadrunner for Seven Sport. Dipper.
Thanks very much, Drew. Well, fantastic atmosphere here. Thousands and thousands of Eagle supporters and plenty of Geelong supporters, is that right? And as I said, everyone is soaking up the atmosphere here, and we're waiting for the players to come along, and we'll catch up with some of the guys.
Good on you, Dipper. And the parade is led in, and we're in Swanston Street, just outside the library, and you can see, well, the town crier leading them off, and motorcycle police from Victoria Police in a formation, and the town crier announces the start of the parade in 1994. And Bernie, I reckon that there's plenty of West Coast Eagles supporters here. They've come over across the Nullarbor, I believe about 14,000 in town. I reckon they've all come to the parade.
Well, it's quite amazing, isn't it, Drew? Well, just listen to the town crier here. And this is terrific for Melbourne. Talk about the national competition. It has really brought interest from right around Australia, this national competition, and there's plenty of West Coast Eagles, as we saw when we were sprinting up the street trying to get here on time, and they're everywhere, the Eagles colours, and plenty of Geelong colours as well, so they're certainly not in their own. We've got a good representation from both sides.
We have, and the Victoria Police doing a great job, not only here in the parade, but in every intersection in town. Now, the first of the big floats with the logo for the 98th AFL Grand Final. And look at those people lining the streets. Well, it reminds me, Bernie, of the Moomba Parade.
Well, it is. It's bigger than the Moomba Parade, just about, Drew. The amount of people, I was really surprised. The city was just about gridlocked as we tried to get up here. And we really just made it in the barest margin of time in the end. But this is fantastic. Football has really come alive. And a magnificent spectacle here in Melbourne.
And the girls out there in all the club colours. Of course, next year there'll be 16 club colours. And so today we're seeing the Fremantle Dockers colours in Melbourne for the first time. There's the old goal umpire. What a success they were at the opening ceremony of the Grand Final a couple of years ago. The Yanks loved them.
Just as long as there's a Fitzroy jumper out there, Drew, I'll be happy. I think I saw one at the end there. Yep, we've got a Fitzroy jumper.
Celebrating a good time to the music of Dragon here in Swanston Street, Melbourne, live at the 1994 Grand Final Parade. To our live coverage of the 1994 Grand Final Parade. Very shortly we'll be speaking to captains and coaches from the West Coast Eagles in Geelong, and seeing the players as they parade down Swanston Street on their way to the National Tennis Centre, where the AFL sensation continues. Now you can see the boundary umpire there. He's on a piece of turf from the MCG, and I've always wondered what went underneath the turf there at the G. They've recently done about $2 million worth of drainage, but I didn't quite realise that under the turf at the MCG was quite what we're seeing here today, Bernie.
Well, there's old hubcaps and headlights and seats and springs. They've got everything under there. A few old steering wheels. I don't think that's exactly a true representation of what's under there, is it, Drew?
No, John Lill, I don't think, would be totally happy with that representation.
Not when they've spent so much money on doing it up, when they're throwing that old stuff underneath.
Now, just behind the goal umpire, we have Calisthenics Guard of Honour from Calisthenics Victoria.
Stay back. You've got a running position.
And I'm feeling for these girls today, Bernie, because it's a bit cold. It's one of those days where you're not sure whether you're going to get a suntan or get belted on by hail.
Well, there was a few spots of rain, wasn't it, just as the parade was about to start. And we thought, well, it would have been typical. Normally, as a parade starts, the rain starts bucketing down, but it seems to be holding off at the moment. But it's not all that warm, Drew. As you said, the girls would be feeling a little bit chilly out there, I would think.
40 girls here representing Calisthenics Victoria. Bonnie Tyler holding out for a hero, the girls from Calisthenics Victoria heralding in the parade of the grand final team in 1994.
Here it comes, y'all. Can you see it?
Back at the grand final parade, and the Clydesdales from CUB making an appearance down Swanston Street. And what a long history of tradition they have, Bernie.
I just wonder, now that CUB is not the major sponsor anymore of the AFL, do we get the Coca-Cola Clydesdales next year?
I don't think so, Drew, but they're magnificent beasts, aren't they? Six of the best-looking horses you'd ever see. They're pulling that cart along Swanston Street. And that's been just something that the CUB has been traditional with grand finals and so forth over the years, and unfortunately they won't be there for much longer, Coca-Cola taking over. But they've always been willing to take part of the parade, and fantastic stuff, CUB.
And just behind the Clydesdales, and thankfully the road is still clear and clean, 35 dancers, all under 5 years of age. The little girls there with their streamers, they look terrific. And there is Greg Williams, the Brownlow medalist, making an appearance. And alongside him is Terry County, who won an AFL sensation competition to ride in the parade with the Brownlow medalist. And down there with Diesel is Dipper, who shared the medal with Diesel in 86. Dipper.
I certainly did, Drew. Now, Diesel, did you miss me the other night when you won your second Brownlow medal?
I did, mate. I was lonely up there, but unfortunately you retired, mate.
Now, a fantastic feeling here today.
Yeah, it is. It's a great crowd here again, and obviously a lot more Geelong supporters than the Eagles. But, you know, it's a great crowd right up the street. And hopefully we won't get wet.
And your prediction for the big game?
I'm a cat, so I'm going for the Cats.
Good on you, Greg. Well done, and congratulations on your second Brownlow medal, mate.
Thanks, Dipper.
Yeah, and what a fantastic winner Greg Williams was on Monday night. Talking there with Dipper, who won it with him in 1986. And Greg Williams waving to the crowd. And in the car right behind Greg Williams, we have Chris Scott, who this year won the Norwich Rising Star. And here's Chris with Dipper.
Thanks very much. Now, Chris, this time last year, what were you doing?
I was probably sitting at home on the bum watching it on telly.
Now, how are you feeling today? A special feeling for everybody here?
Yeah, it's fantastic. I can't believe the amount of people that have turned out, and should be a good event.
Now, the Bears for next year, what do you think of their predictions?
I think finals would have to be a go-dipper.
Finals, already talking about finals, you get that feeling already.
Yeah, I've watched a few finals the last couple of weeks, so I'm pretty keen and I reckon we should be a show.
And your predictions?
Geelong.
Well done.
Thanks, Dippo. There's Chris Scott, and there's a Geelong fan in the crowd. Already with the, not the painted face, but with the transfer on the cheek. And really, grand final fever has hit Melbourne. There's no doubt about that.
I tell you what, Drew, the game's got a big future when we see young blokes like Chris Scott. He's been magnificent this year, hasn't he? And a real credit to himself and his family, and a worthy winner of the Norwich Rising Star Award.
And a great competition to offer a cash prize to somebody who's just starting out in his AFL career. What a terrific bonus. $10,000
absolutely.
In the skyrocket.
Unlucky for Corey McKernan, of course, from North Melbourne, but that's the way it goes. But Chris Scott, really a worthy winner of that award.
Now, the painted face with Geelong and West Coast Eagles colours, about 4 metres high, the painted face, and very shortly we'll be seeing the two competing teams. The parade this year, really with a lot of pizzazz and choreography, the dancers and the calisthenics, it's been terrific.
Well, it is getting bigger and bigger, isn't it, Drew? Year by year, it was a bit of a hassle, I thought, in the early days for the teams to be represented, but they seem to be taking a bigger interest in this parade, and certainly the people have shown a great interest by turning out in their thousands.
And the girls here behind the floater from the May Downs Dance School.
Enthusiasm. They're pretty young, some of these girls, too. They'd be probably as young as 5 or 6, a few of these here, I would think.
Yes, I'd say so.
Maybe even a couple younger than that.
Yeah. And what a shame, just a few spots of rain. It threatens to rain on this parade.
The sky's looking very nasty over to the south. I think we might get a bit of a bucketing down at some stage, too.
Playing to win, it's the sort of song that makes you want to go out and have a kick, Bern.
That's probably the thing that Malcolm Blunt will be playing, or Mickey Mott has to be playing before the game tomorrow. The sort of stirring music that they often play in the dressing rooms before a game.
The Eagles will be the first team to make an appearance in the parade, and they're just off down there behind the pom-poms. And we'll be back at the grand final parade to meet members of the Eagles after a short break. Welcome back to the grand final parade, and the team's about to make their appearance, and out on the roadway here's Dipper with the Eagles.
Thanks very much, Drew. Well, we have the coach and the captain of the West Coast. Mick, I couldn't sleep in last night.
You went in pretty late, Dip, so we've had our training session this morning, so it's been a pretty hectic sort of first few hours, but we'll get this over with, and we'll get home, we'll get to the hotel and have a bit of a breather.
Now, there's a lot of support for you guys here this year. Everywhere we go, it's West Coast Eagles!
Well, I think half West Australia over here. It's fantastic.
Now, Captain, how you feeling?
Yeah, good, Dipper. Enjoying it, mate.
Now, when do you get out of your Clark Kent uniform and become that tough man?
Well, I've got a job to do tomorrow, so I'll be doing my best.
All right, mate. Good on you.
Mick Malthouse, the coach, and John Worsfold, the captain. Well, they've been here as a team three times now in grand finals. They lost in 91. They beat Geelong in 92. And now they're in amongst the crowd. And a mixed reception for the Eagles, but I can promise there are plenty of West Australians here.
Plenty of support for the Eagles. There's Glenn Jagovic, Peter Sumich, David Hart, Chris Waterman, Peter Wilson. The boys, they're moving through pretty quickly here. There we see Peter Wilson, been an ex-Richmond player, and now representing the West Coast Eagles, of course, in the grand final. Drew Banfield and Ryan Turnbull. They're a bit harder to pick out of the uniforms too, aren't they? Don Pike.
And Tony Evans, who had to pass a bit of a fitness test during the week. And we don't know for 100% certain how the Eagles will line up, whether they'll line up as picked.
No, well, of course, there'll be a bit of to-ing and fro-ing coming into the game as far as which players will be out there. And, of course, you would expect that. There's Peter Matera, runner-up in the Brownlow medal with 28 votes alongside the ruckman. David Hines, number one ruckman, who's made a resurgence over the last few weeks with the West Coast Eagles.
Ashley McIntosh, back from injury, there with Guy McKenna. One looks a bit different in the glasses, doesn't he?
He does, but he's one of the best defenders in the competition, Guy McKenna. As Peter McKenna keeps reminding us. Dean Kemp and Brett Heddy. Heddy, who was a match winner last week for the West Coast Eagles against Melbourne, played a fantastic game.
Carl Langdon gets a trip. Doesn't get a game of footy, but he gets a trip over to Melbourne.
Where are the boos for Carl? I thought there would have been a few for him.
Riding in the open Saab Australia 900 Cabriolets. And Chris Mainwaring and Chris Lewis, the last of the Eagles players through. And now Geelong to the club theme song. Welcome to the Cats.
Well, they've been here three times as well, Drew. Two losing grand finals.
And here's Dipper with Malcolm Blake.
Thanks very much, Drew. Well, another grand final for the Cats. Exciting feeling here at the parade.
Fantastic, isn't it? It's a big crowd looking down the road.
And when did you arrive in town?
About 40 minutes ago.
And all the boys will go back tonight and sleep in their own beds?
Oh, yes. No, we'll go back and train this afternoon.
Now, Mark, how's the side preparing? Preparing well for the big one?
Yeah, we'll just have a light run tonight, Dipper, and get ready for tomorrow.
Do you think the wet grounds will suit Geelong?
It rains 3 inches overnight, Dipper.
Good on you, buddy. Well done. Congratulations.
We are Geelong. We're always on the board.
Now, as the girls with their pom-poms and the Geelong flags lead the Geelong team through, there's Blighty. Good luck, mate. And Mark Fairstow. Stephen Handley and Johnny Barnes look a bit cold, the boys.
Just a slight drizzle on the parade at the moment. It's not too bad. Billy Brownless and Paul Couch.
Ken Hinckley and Gary Hocking. And what an important component Gary Hocking might be in tomorrow's game.
Well, that midfield will be very important.
Andrew Wills and Michael Mansfield named All-Australian last week. Lee Tudor, who kicked that one to Gary Ablett last week. He'll be remembered forever for it. There's Stephen Hocking in the middle. Gary's brother, you hardly hear much about him. With Adrian Hickmott.
Big cheer now for the Geelong boys, and that's why it is. There's Gary Ablett under the umbrella there. I can't see who the other player was, but a big cheer for Gary Ablett.
Yeah, I think Gazza got a special cheer. And what a finals run the Cats have had, winning two games with kicks after the siren. And their other win was when they had their three men of the engine room out and they still got over Carlton.
Yes, I think they're playing on a high at the moment, Geelong. It'll be a fantastic game tomorrow. And when you consider that the Eagles have come over a couple of times, Drew, and have failed dismally against Collingwood at the MCG and also against Carlton out of Princes Park. So there's nothing sure in football and there's no certainty, although the West Coast Eagles are the favourites, I would think that Geelong will run them right to the wire.
40 dancers here from the Baronia School of Dance. And they're followed by the Z-Class trams. And, the Met has proved a vital part of transportation in Melbourne. Actually, we thought there might be a strike this weekend. Fortunately, there hasn't been. But you know that last year, The Met moved 30,000 people on Grand Final Day, and they obviously have a busy day again to get people into the MCG and back out. And the streets behind the trams are starting to crowd up with the fans who are breaking through the barriers, and they'll be following the parade and the two teams down to the National Tennis Centre, where the AFL sensation continues, and the teams will have their media conference, which starts a tradition on Grand Final Eve. We'll be back soon.
Here comes the big parade.
Well, hope you had a great time with the Grand Final Parade. I can assure you thousands of people in Swanston Street in Melbourne did. Here we are, two Brownlow medals between us, Bernie and Dipper.
That's my support crew here, Drew.
I thought they were yelling Bernie. Now, what was the story out there while you were interviewing Mick Malthouse? Well,
as you said, as I was interviewing Mick, the car tyre went over my foot. So I think he asked the young girl to go over my foot, and as I was asking the question, they had a big tyre and about 3 tonnes on my foot. I'm all right.
You've put up with pain before. Yeah, who do you reckon for tomorrow?
He usually screams to the umpire for a free kick, whatever, do you, Dipper? Tomorrow I'm going for Geelong without any confidence, but I think over here there's no certainty. West Coast Eagles going to as the favourites, but I think Geelong, the third time in, will really give a great account of themselves. They've come through the finals, two wins after the siren, and that great win over Carlton when they're undermanned. So I think that just everything's going with them at the moment. They've had plenty of finals experience in Melbourne, that's the other thing.
Now, Bertie, you've wrapped it up in one.
For me, different way you go.
And because I'm a Victorian, because I want the cup to stay here, I want Geelong to win. So Geelong for me, Drew.
Good on you, Dipper. Now, just before we leave the parade, it's a big weekend on Seven Sport, as you can imagine, and it continues later on this evening at 7:30. We have the Grand Final Countdown, live from the Playbox Theatre. Check your local guides for details. It goes for 3 hours. And then the Footy Marathon, Paul Salmon hosting this year. It starts at 10:30. And then tomorrow morning, well, we start with the North Melbourne breakfast. The under-18s are at 9 o'clock. The reserves of the VSFL at 11 o'clock, and the senior game at 2 o'clock. What a weekend it should be for football, and don't forget the Tuohy's 1000 on Sunday. All on 7 Sport. Hope you can be with us over the weekend.
This has been a 7 Sport production.